Hi everyone, this is Chloe. I'm going to start a little tutorial series in Star Trek Online. This is for the Risa Summer Event. This is where you first beam in. And one of the things you want to do for this event is usually every year they have a new ship that you can win. And it's down here under Reputations, the Events tab. And if you didn't have a project going, I already have this project going. But it's to claim the Hor'ghan Zephyrus Heavy Escort Tier 6 for summer 2016. And it looks like I did not put my favors in here from last night. So I'm getting ready to go and do that right now. To be able to do this event, you need to have a jetpack. And if you don't have a jetpack, the jetpack, when you get it, it goes in your device slot, and then you have to assign it to a button if it does not automatically assign it to one. But I like to keep it on the numbered buttons, that way I can activate it easily at will instead of having to click on it, and I can just press 4 to activate it, press 4 to shut it off. But I'll show you where you can get your floater. Well, where you can buy all of the items for the summer event. Now, the summer event requires a trading item called the Lohlunat Favor, where people just call them favors for short. And I don't currently have any in my inventory, but I'm about to get some. But you buy just about everything with the favors. If you don't have a floater, you can rent one for energy credits, and I don't remember how long it lasts. I think it's like 9 or 10 minutes. I don't remember. It's been like 3 years since I've had one, because I rented one to get the favors, and the one I have currently is the Superior Black. It also helps to have the Lohlunat Triple, which as you can see right there, it gives you plus 2.5 psionic resistance rating for an hour, plus 0.03 health regeneration for an hour, and during the summer event, it's plus 5 flight speed. That's pertaining to your floater. So you actually end up moving a little faster, and I already have the buffs on here from last night because I was not on here for a full hour. But yeah, you just click on it. She pets her little tribble. And it coos at her, and she gets the buff for an hour. And the way you get the tribble is you have to already have a tribble. Like, I have the Rikasa tribble. They just call it Rick for short, but it's actually the Rikasa tribble. And as you can see, it gives you a plus 1.5% to all damage for an hour, and a plus 1.5 to damage resistance for an hour. Another thing would be nice to have for this event, if you want to do it, is they have something called the Powerboard Race. And that, again, you would buy here if you don't already have it in your under the Z store, because if you've been on here for so long, or if you've been on here during the special promotions, you just go to promotions, and right there it says it's available. If it's not available, it'll have a price. But if it's something you can just claim for free, you got it available. And if you have this one, I do recommend it. It is pretty fast. It's a pretty nice board. But anyway, you have back to the Lohlunat Trouble To get the Lohlunat Treble, you have to go to this vendor. And buy any one of these consumable food items. And about an hour sitting in your inventory, so long as it's like right beside the treble, like you may have to move your treble and then move the food item right beside it. After about an hour, that treble will breed. Those trebles eat and then they like asexually reproduce. And from eating the Risian food, you end up with the Lohlunat Treble. And it can be gotten with any treble. You just need to have the Risian food for it. And right now, I'm going to go take care of my event and show you a tip for it. I usually shut off my floater when I'm talking to her, because once you get the mission from her, and the mission won't start up right away if you already have your floater on, you have to turn your floater on, or if it's already on, you have to turn it off and then turn it back on to get the places you have to fly to. I'm just going to talk to her, flying high, and this has changed this year. Normally you could only do this once per day, but now you can do it every 15 minutes, but only once per day can you get the prize vouchers to get the ship. So that's still only once every 20 hours. But if you do it every 15 minutes, then you get favors. So you could just keep doing this all day and get favors. And now, as I'm done talking to her, I can activate my floater. And then you just follow these tracks. I have to go through three of these courses. And I do recommend the Superior Floater because it's faster and more maneuverable. The other ones drift a lot, very hard to control, and they're not as fast. And they drift a lot. Okay, and you can see up here in these arrows pointing you in the direction. The bigger the arrow, the closer the track is you have to go to. Please excuse my roommate's dog. very loud puppy. Yes, she is a puppy. I'm not real sure exactly what she is. She kind of looks like a black lab. She's very cute, but very loud. Looks like that's the next one. Or I should say, the last one that I have to do. Right now, anyway. Oh, another thing you can buy is a change of outfit. It's swimwear with the favors. And then beam back to the resort. Now the tip that I have is they used to have a counter on when you can do the flying high again to get what you need to get the prize vouchers. But they did away with the counter. The counter used to be like up here. It would tell you you have so many hours, minutes, seconds remaining before you can do it again. But they did away with that, and I'm not real sure why. So my tip on how to, so you know when you can do it again to get the prize vouchers, is go into your duty officers and start a 20-hour duty officer mission. When these complete, you know it's time to go get your prize voucher, do the flying high again to get your prize vouchers. So I'm just going to do my beam research, because that takes 20 hours. And I'm going to do my shield research too. So when these are done, I will know I can go and get my prize vouchers again. And I'm not going to do the Hor'ghan Hunt right now or this Powerboard Race. I'm just going to take a little break here and get ready for the dance-off. This is where you have to go for the dance-off. But I will show you how to set this up. instead of having to type into the chat here, and I can't remember exactly what it is, I think it's /e-dance. Yep, that's it. And then you click on one of these dances, it's called, where you can just finish typing it out and press enter. The dance instructor will call out a type of dance for you to do. And instead of having to type that out, the best way is to click on this little icon here, go to emotes, and click on this little pin to pin that menu here, then drag it up and center your dances here on the screen. That way you can just click on them. So Chloe mixes things up a little. Chloe brings down the house. Chloe is tearing up the dance floor. And the only dances that the instructor will call out is the, he or she will say, just dance. That is the dance mix. It's not the dance basic. It is the dance mix. A lot of people get that confused and end up not getting the points for it. But it is the dance mix. And they'll call out the club dance. They'll call out the leg kick. They'll call out raise the roof. They'll call out do the robot. They'll call out the sidestep. They'll call out the snake. The running man. And wave your hands. These others, like the samba, you get the samba here. And the way you get that, if I can even remember how to do it, as I've had it for like 3 years, but you get both of these here. You go and talk to the dance instructor. which at least 3 years ago, the damn instructor hung out around here somewhere. She will have a little icon above her head. And if you hover your cursor over her, it'll say dance instructor, I believe. But she should be some. Oh, there she is. And I don't remember which option you click on because I already have it. But there's an option here to click on, and she ends up teaching you how to do the samba. And then after you complete the dance off, come back and talk to her after the event is over. And then she will teach you the samba advanced. Another one that you might not have. Well, the Ferengi dance, you buy that with Gold Press Latinum. And another one that you might not have is the dance fan. You get that on Nimbus 3, and I'll do a tutorial later on how to do that. So I do have a character who doesn't have it yet. But I'll get back out here onto the dance floor. Then I'll pause this recording to get ready for when the dance begins. After I set this back up. Again, if you need to know, you just click this little icon here, go to emotes, and click on the little pin icon, and drag it up, and scroll down to get all your dances ready. That way, as soon as they're called, because you only have a few seconds to do this, as soon as it's called, you click on it. And the you'll get points up here for it, which turn into Lohlunat Favors. So you can buy things like the floaters or the swimwear or a power board, whatever you need to do the other events at this summer event. Well, I'm going to pause this for now. Okay, the dance is going to be starting here soon. Okay, the dance party is starting here. Just click on I want to dance or I want to dance. Yeah, the dance party is starting soon. Do the snake. Just dance, that's the mix. Got 10 favors for completing 3 of those. Now to complete 5 more, and I believe you get 15 favors from that. I like to hover my mouse right around the middle here. That way you only have half the distance to move your mouse to do these, but she gives you enough time. You don't really have to do that. I just like to do it. Yep, 15. Lohlunat Favors. Oh yeah, if she's already called it, you don't have to click it again. It'll automatically give you the point. But I just clicked it again because I was just being absent-minded for a moment. And mix. There is music playing, but I have the music shut off because I don't want to raise the roof. Yeah. There's music playing in this part of the game, but I have it shut off because I don't want a DMAC complaint against me or against my channel. And when you do the dance mix, it's a mixture of all the dances that she calls. She'll change randomly. When you complete this dance off, you end up with 100 Lohlunat Favors. So you can get, I believe you can get one of the low grade floaters with that, I think. I don't remember how much they cost. I'd have to go back and check. Oh, raise the roof. It's here. I have to complete 20 more. And this is the last level of it. After the 20, the event's over. Bunch of little chihuahuas just decided to lose their mind because my boyfriend's aunt is at the door. Three more. Two more. Last one coming up. And that's it. I'm going to go and get ready to show you the powerboard races. Okay, and I'm going to do a tutorial here for the powerboard race. Just waiting for the event to start. When it starts, if you're not already here, you will have a prompt to beam to race start, and you'll just pop up right over here. But you will need a powerboard for this race. And you also have to assign it to a button, which I've assigned it here. The way I control my power board is the same way I control my character. If you hold down the right mouse button and move your mouse around, you can turn. If you hold down both buttons, you will move in the direction that you're facing. And join race. And keep a finger on the space bar, you will need it. Spacebar makes you jump. If you jump at the high point of these ramps, you'll get a speed boost, like I just got. I missed that one. Also, going over these items here gives you a speed boost. Okay. Yeah, or not sure which place I got. Let's see. Got 75, so it looks like I got either first or second place. And that's how you do it. I kind of don't like the fact that you actually have to press the F button to finish the race, because if you go too far or get off your board, then you're disqualified from the race. It makes it a pain in the butt. They should just have a sensor at the finish for whoever crosses it first. That's how it should be, but you actually have to grab a flag at the end to finish the race. Kind of makes it a major pain in the... Okay, I'm back to show you the Hor'ghan Hunt. Begins in a minute, and I'll show you the best place to start. Just fly over top of the resort. And right back here, there's a little mound of dirt and flowers. Get right by this flower here. Sometimes there's a Hor'ghan that pops up right here, and if it's not here, then there'll be one right back there between those trees. And it's, again, it's best to have the Lohlunat trouble for this because it gives you a faster flight speed. And get ready to click the button when it pops up here. Okay, yep, it's right back here. Now, when I do this, I usually do it with multiple characters, as I farm the favors, and you'll be seeing me do this in this video here. I have all my characters at that ready position. Let's fly down through these trees, because the next Hor'ghan is right here. And fly up right between these trees. And right between these trees here. And then right on top of that hill that I'm aiming above now. And then the next one will be right between those, right in the valley between those two rock mountains. And the next one will be over here near the stone archway. It's like inside of this route. Next one will be between these two trees, and I'm aiming between. And the next one will be down in the valley between these two big hills. The next one will be over top of this hill. Come down right between these trees. And that's the last Hor'ghan. You have to turn in the mission to get the bonus. And then instead of taking my character back, I just switch over to the next character. Yep, one's right here. This is what my friends and I call the long run, because there's one Hor'ghan that's way out of the way to grab. And go up between these trees, and instead of going through those trees as we did previously, now the next Hor'ghan is down by this. Rock hill, and then between these trees, right up against the cliff edge. And this is where the next one is. The reason why we call this one the long run is because this Hor'ghan's way over here, right by this twisted tree. Or bent tree. All the other trees in this game seem to be pretty straight. And the next one is right over inside this root here, or right below it. And then right up on top of this hill. And then instead of going down into that valley, it's still down in the valley, but it's up in this direction. And the next one will be through those trees. Just gotta run back here to grab it. Short run. Yeah, whenever I park my characters back here, I park them and activate the treble. Because the treble's countdown stops when you're not logged on to that character. So, and it has an hour countdown on it, so you don't have to worry about it running out. And whenever I at the end of this run, when I take all the characters back to where they need to go, I'm going to restart the trouble. Although I won't really need to, it's just a good habit. That way you don't forget to do it. Because it's really hard to run five characters through this. I try to do six. I've never been able to do six. And I have the superior floater and the treble, and I still can't do six characters through this completely. My best run that I had, my sixth character, I had three more organs to find by the time the mission ended. So I imagine if all of the Hor'ghans popped up like right at the beginning, if I got the long run every time, then I could get it. I could probably get six characters through it. But there's no way to guarantee that you're going to get the long run every time. It's always random. But though it's random, for like the first 3 days of this event, I thought they completely did away with the short run, because all I ever got was the long run for like 3 days straight, and I did the Hor'ghan Hunt multiple times a day, and all I ever got was the short run. I've been doing this event for 3 years, so I've got it down pretty well exactly where I need to be and when I need to start decelerating to land right by the Hor'ghan to pick it up. So just starting out, you probably won't be able to run five characters through this, but with practice, you should definitely be able to. And you surely won't be able to run five characters through this without the superior floater. Starting to lag there. Closed it too soon. for the short run, the Hor'ghan's going to be right in this area here, somewhere, I think, closer to this tree here. And for the long run, I'm sorry, for the short run, it's going to be over here. For the long run, it's going to be over here. And I'm currently doing the long run, so I need to retarget myself over here. Puppies again. Oh, that wasn't a puppy, that was one of the adult chihuahuas. I think it was probably Maggie. And she would be my sixth one. I know I'm not going to have enough time to complete her. Never do. Yeah, 17 seconds, yeah. So I'm not even going to do it. I will restart her thing, though. Then I will show you the next part. After the Hor'ghan Hunt finishes, and you've got your characters out there, you just go back to each character. And it helps to have an account bank for this. If you don't have an account bank, I think you can use the mail system for this. And just teleport back to the resort. And fly into the resort. I'm not sure if they have mail here or not. I know that they have the, yeah, they got mail. Yeah. But I have an account bank. And then I reposition her, getting her ready for the next Hor'ghan Hunt. And reset her trouble. I don't want to race. What happens when you click too quick without looking? I went site-to-site transport to the resort. If you are starting the summer event now, it is too late to get the ship. However, you still can come to the summer event and farm Hor'ghans like I am here, like I'm showing you how to do now. You can make a lot of money doing this. So far this event... Oh, I forgot to reset her. I've got to reset her trouble, although she doesn't need it, but still. It's, again, good habit to do it. My mouse is laggy because I discovered that when I tried to record this before, even though I had it set to capture the mouse, the game would not let it capture the mouse. Because for some reason the game is using hardware for the mouse. Cursor. I had to set it in the options to use software for the mouse. And for some reason that is making the mouse lag really bad. So definitely when I'm not recording these, I will be putting it back to or turning off the software mouse. As it sucks having this mouse lag. So yeah, 517 Lohlunat Favors, and yeah, I just got the Hor'ghan Zevius heavy escort today. Go into the exchange and drag this over to there and search. Okay, that's the going rate for each individual favor. If you go over here and click on that drop down menu, go to sort by ascending price per unit, and then search again. That's how much the current bundles are going for, and oh, they've gone up in price. Evidently, people have stopped doing these so much, so yeah, now would be a good time to start farming these. I would only put in 100 at a time, otherwise they're going to be too expensive to sell a whole lot of. And check that price again. Okay. Yeah, I'm going to try for 3.8. Yeah, you have to put in the price for the total. I've seen people who have evidently got that confused and put a whole bundle of 100 in there for just, yeah, 3,890 or whatever, thinking it would just multiply it for them, and it didn't. And I kind of took advantage of that, because when I seen it, I bought them so I could resell them at a higher price. And I'm not very good with math in my head, so pull the calculator up here. And that's it. Eventually, these should sell pretty shortly, and I'll have quite a bit of money. I already do have some, but I've spent it recently. I was able to, I believe I started mentioning it earlier and forgot, doing these Hor'ghan hunts and farming the favors like I do. I was able to save up 35 million that I needed to get a duty officer for making this gun here. This gun is definitely the gun you want on elite ground missions. It's 100% shield penetration. It kills things pretty quick. And the duty officer that you need is for R&D ground school. And it cost like 35 million. I also ended up getting her the plasmonic leech, which is, well, I'll go into that in another tutorial.
Hello, YouTube viewers. Today on Risa, D Squared S Productions is going to show you how to do an artifact scavenger hunt. Okay, first step. You need to pick up the mission here on the right-hand side. It will show you a button that says, I want to hunt for artifacts. Go ahead and pick up the mission. Accept. Now, the next step will be a button here pops up that says Initialize Artifact Scanner. Initialize your artifact scanner. Now, turn on a floater. If you have a simple floater or a rental, that's fine. I have a superior floater. It's much faster and stops. It's more maneuverable. Now move forward a bit. Click search for artifact, which will pop up. Depending on how close you are away from the artifact, it will say whether you are further or closer to the object you are looking for. Move a ways and scan again. Now, as you can see, there was a red field area that popped up. Anywhere within that red area, the artifact can be in that direction. So let's move a ways and scan again. Now the artifact is this way. At a few various scans, you eventually will triangulate the point down to where the artifact is. And that is how you do an artifact hunt.